six-time world champion.
I'm trying to go 7-8.
Maybe coming up. Speaking of which, what do you think of Pacquiao Spence? You're a southpaw, just like them.
I think it's going to be great, man. You know, two legends going at it. It's going to be a little tricky. It's going to be a great fight. You know, you can never count Pacquiao out. I always say Filipinos at 40 years old is like 20, man.
Well, let me tell you something that a lot of people watching this don't know. A young Robert Guerrero was in the ring sparring Manny Pacquiao. Remind people, what was the sparring like, Robert? It was legendary.
Pretty much, they just took everybody's cameras. Didn't let nobody let it out, or no reporters write about it. So it was great, though, man. You know,
Manny's a legend. Hey,
but you know what? Out of respect for Freddie, you know, sparring, and I always say that what happens in sparring is only sparring.
That's true. But I'm saying
with those 8 ounces, come on, it's a whole different story.
No. But what I'm trying to get at is that you shared the ring with him, which is legendary.
Yeah.
And
oh, definitely.
So what does he need to do to win? What does Spence need to do to win?
Pacquiao just needs to be Pacquiao, man. Use those fast hands. Like, everybody was looking at him and
Thurman.
Thurman, yeah. Everybody's looking at him and Thurman, and we're just like, oh, man, he's a big guy. And all of a sudden, you see Thurman on his ass. So, you know, you can never count Manny out. Those fast hands, and the last thing to go is your punching power. And from the look of Manny, his speed hasn't diminished at all.
When you sparred him, the footwork, the speed, the power, what was impressive?
Everything, you know, how quick he was, his hands, his movement, and then also too, a lot of people don't realize how herky-jerky he is in the ring. You know, so you got to kind of gauge on that because of all the.
You don't know where he's gonna blast off. Okay.
So, I think with Spence just has to use a great jab.
And he has that.
And if you look at him and Marquez, it was always timing. It was always timing with Marquez and that jab. So,
It's a great fight.
I think it's gonna be a great fight.
Are you gonna be there?
Yeah, for sure. I want to be there.
Now, you may be coming back into the ring. There's a lot of talk, a lot of buzz in boxing. Robert Guerrero back in the ring in July. Stay tuned. You'll give him all the updates.
Oh, yeah.
But what can we expect? You look like in great shape. You just sparred how many rounds?
Eight rounds.
And you're talking to me like it's nothing. Oh, it's not easy to spar one round.
No, you know what? Before, early in my career, I just trained, you know, work out hard, fight. Then don't even watch no film, nothing. Just keep going. Boom. Hey, what's the next fight? Let's go. And, you know, spiraled out of control, developed a bunch of bad habits, and you know, on the comeback, my father just straight up said, hey, you know what, if you're gonna do this again, you better use all the skills that you're God-given, and that's what I've been doing. So, you know, like boxing, using my jab, working behind everything, using my legs. So, you know, the rest is nice, and especially COVID did good for me.
For Guerrero, you fought a lot of legendary names, but one of the names you shared a ring with was Floyd Money Mayweather. And sure. Robert Cruz is fighting on Mayweather's card, yeah. June 6th.
Pedro Cruz.
What do you think about Mayweather and Logan Paul, first of all?
I think it's a great money move for Floyd, man. You know, hey, he's a young guy. He's fighting, big guy. But everybody knows, man, it's hard to match skills in boxing. You know, I don't care how big you are. You could get a heavyweight like Andre the Giant, man.
And what would you do to him?
And Mayweather will still catch him with the shot and break his nose.
So if Mayweather went in there and fought, like, let me think, who's like Anthony Davis from the Lakers, 7'1", it doesn't matter, 6'11"?
It doesn't matter, man. Floyd,
LeBron James,
you just got to throw an air punch by him and he'll fall.
But in boxing, Mayweather fights at 147, Logan Paul walks around 200+. But you're saying it doesn't matter. Well, if you have skills?
Yeah, you know, Floyd's going to be on his game like he always is. I mean, you look what he does to the best fighters in the world. They can barely even touch him. Imagine a big guy that walks around at, what does he walk around? What is it, 2-something?
210, I think. 210. And he's going to be 190 for the fight.
His speed he has is, I mean, you can't match it to Pacquiao. You can't match it to Canelo.
You're saying Mayweather's faster than him?
Oh, definitely.
Mayweather's faster than Pacquiao?
I'm talking about reaction.
Yeah.
I'm talking about reaction.
Reflexes.
Because when I fought Floyd, he was reacting to my blinks. And people don't realize that when they get in the ring with Floyd, it is his reaction time to what you do is makes the difference, and his timing. So, you know, I don't see this guy, you know, not even doing anything. I don't even think Floyd's gonna let him hit him.
You know, Bruce Lee has a martial art called the Way of the Intercepting Fist, and part of that philosophy is anticipating what your opponent's gonna do before they do it. So yeah. Mayweather's very good at that. He knows.
I think. You know, Bruce Lee was a master at that, and then there's Floyd Mayweather.
But Mayweather is also very smart. He knows when to win, when to hit. His defense is great.
Oh yeah, everything all around.
And the money, how could you have 50 and 0 and a billionaire?
Like I said, man, you're making $107 million to spar.
So what have you seen Floyd since you guys fought? Do you have any relation with him? Like hello, goodbye, or?
No, I've seen him at some of the fights and stuff like that.
You he's very respectful.
Oh yeah, definitely. And, you know, everything's all game, you know, and you know, when it comes to a fight, selling a fight, you know, getting in there, intimidation, you know, that psychological warfare, you know, you got to do it.
What would you do different, Robert, in a rematch? If the opportunity came up and they said, Robert, you and Mayweather, round two.
I would throw a lot more punches, man. But then that being said, you know, like I said, it's reacting to what you do, you know. And he says it best. Everybody has a game plan until they get in the ring.
Yeah, that's true.
True.
Like
I mean,
Mike Tyson.
I had the perfect game plan to beat him. I can guess everybody did.
Canelo, are you a southpaw? Yep.
You know, everybody that's getting in with him. But, you know, just, you know, he can change things on the turn of a dime.